The second story from the easternmost province of Indonesia, Papua, is explored by Albertus Febrianto. It takes about 5 hours non-stop flight from Jakarta, the Indonesian capital, to arrive in Jayapura, the capital of Papua province. It is not only far away geographically, but also seemingly distant from the heart of most Indonesian people. A diptych series of Hembri's images show us a fragment of practice against human rights principles toward Papuan people. He wrote in his statement, "Papua is a resource-rich area, although it is considered an area with a high level of poverty, while requests for equality and justice by indigenous Papuans are always equated with separatist sentiments."
I got my first assignment to Papua in 2009. A 7-week trip to 6 districts at the time emphasized how difficult it was to access the issues of Papua, either access to geography, language, or political barriers. The fact that was borne out by the indigenous Papua whom I met during the visit raised more questions in my head. Why are the repeated stories of violence experienced by Papuans? How poverty can occur in abundant land, etc. In 2015, I decided to move to Papua with the intention of making stories about Papua based on those questions. This ongoing project is actually like a series of conversations between me, my friends, and a number of Papuans who are willing to share their stories.
As a freelance photojournalist, Febri dedicates his life to give voice to Papuan people. In 2019, he was recognized for his strong body of work by being selected as one of the emerging photographers from Southeast Asia and Oceania for the 6 Basic Global Talent Program by WordPress Photo.